At North Dallas High School in Texas, could pass the state skills test in math. 3 years later, 91% passed. What happened? John Saxon says the students and teachers just applied his common sense approach to learning math.
Plus one half, hot doggy stuff with a plus one half, a plus one half. Oh man, this stuff is so easy. He's taking Calculus 1 as a junior. He can do anything he wants to do in life.
America's heritage, America's discipline. But America is falling behind the rest of the world in all three, especially arithmetic. The nation's governors acknowledged that this past weekend when they endorsed the president's goal of making U.S. students number one in math and science by the year 2000. An ambitious goal because our high school students score lower in math than any other industrialized nation in the world. Well, John Saxon says he knows why Americans are falling behind. We've been teaching math the wrong way, he says. The right way, he says, is to keep going over the same math problem again and again until the student knows the answer as well as his own name. This crusty 66-year-old former combat pilot and Air Force Academy teacher has written a series of math textbooks that he says will turn the tables, that will improve our math students' test scores and help them to compete with the rest of the world. Back in 1985, just 10% of the juniors here at North Dallas High School in Texas could pass the state skills test in math. 3 years later, 91% passed. What happened? John Saxon says the students and teachers just applied his common sense approach to learning math.
Y'all are real lucky to be in this school and in this book, because we're going to keep doing it, and we're going to keep doing it, and we're going to keep doing it. And this thing that we did today, that's the wildest, hairy thing I have ever seen in my life. Huh? There's no way you're going to understand that on one day. But we're going to have two tomorrow. We're going to have two the next day. We're going to have two the next day. We're going to have one the next day. And eventually, these will become just as simple as those sign number problems that were so difficult at the beginning.
You mean that's the Saxon method?
Yes.
Just repetition until it becomes part of your life. Well,
yes, it's repetition, but it's also building. And you must repeat things that are worthwhile. You can't repeat things that are not worth remembering. So you must isolate the fundamental skills, the things that are necessary to survive in the marketplace, the things that are necessary to do physics, the same as necessary to do chemistry and calculus.
And Saxon says that students who use his books never have a chance to forget what they've learned because his constant review and practice won't let them. That's unlike traditional math books, where a student learns a problem and then moves on to something completely new and forgets what he learned last week or last month. In Saxon's books, the problems you learn in Lesson 1 show up again in Lesson 40. In fact, of the 30 homework problems assigned each day, only 5 are new problems, the rest are review. He discovered his common sense approach to math after he retired from the military to teach algebra at an Oklahoma junior college and found his students couldn't remember what he taught them.
I realized that the way I was teaching was not successful, and I said, what would happen if we practiced everything every night for the whole year? And my roommate said immediately, he said, you'd have 150 problems. I said, maybe not. He said, you wouldn't have room but for 3 of the new kind, and that wouldn't be enough for them to get it.
Right.
I said, ha, they don't get it now. It can't be any worse. You see,
so Saxon sat down at his dining room table and wrote an algebra book. Then he mortgaged his home to publish it 10 years ago when he discovered he was onto something.
Then I ran a test in 20 Oklahoma schools, 1,300 students, a year-long test in 1980-81. The students who used my book outscored the others by 159%. And so I felt that it was worthwhile. I knew that I had a winner. I knew I had a way to do it, and I felt I could take a chance. Plus one half, hot doggy. So I put a plus one half, a plus one half. Oh, man, this stuff is so easy.
The students who used his books were not only scoring higher, he found they were less intimidated by math and were actually taking more math in high school and liking it. So Saxon hit the road, evangelizing about the results of his practice and review approach to teachers and educators at math conferences across the country. But there were tough criticisms.
A lot of people say, I don't like Saxon. All he does is blind mindless drill. Now these same people say, Van Cliburn, all he does is drill the piano. All Joe Montana does is go to football drill. Jack Nicklaus goes to the drill team. there is a difference between drill and practice. You must practice everything to get it. This is any skill, including mental skills. Yes, ma'am.
We're not trying to turn students into little machines that can operate and do the same things as an electronic calculator. And that, to me, is what your materials are starting to do to kids.
Teachers are sharply divided between those who like the Saxon approach and those who don't like it at all.
Let's not get into a dogfight. Ma'am, wait a minute. No. This is my session. Don't come into my session to give me trouble.
But Saxon is in a continuing dogfight with a lot of his critics who say his results are based on rote memorization and that students will soon forget what they learned from Saxon and won't be able to perform in jobs that require more and more math problem solving. They say Saxon is just out of step with the times. Dr. Elizabeth Stage is president of the California Math Council.
John Saxon wants to do better at the things that we have been doing in the past, getting kids to make computations quickly and accurately, getting kids to manipulate algebraic symbols quickly and accurately.
What's wrong with that?
That's not good enough.
Why?
We need kids to be able to make sense.
And what does that mean?
That means solving complex problems.
Like?
Like, what's a reasonable estimate of the amount of money that you should plan for to do something that you want to do, take a trip?
And you have to go to math class to find that out?
Where else are you going to learn that? We need people who can make sense of the quantitative information in their lives. That means they can make decisions about mortgages, they can make decisions about personal planning, they can read the paper intelligently, they can function well on the job.
Saxon says that's what the critics have been saying about him for years.
He's not teaching them to think, he's not teaching them to create. All they can do is do the college boards and score 20% higher, but it's obvious he does not teach them how to think. And I can't understand how students who score 20% higher on the college boards, who get 18 months of calculus in high school, are not being taught what we want them to know.
I would like more for kids. I would like them to understand new and unexpected situations, to be able to solve problems that they've never seen before.
Saxon says his goal is to give students a strong foundation in math, to expose students to calculus and trigonometry in high school, to help students pass their SAT exams and their college entrance tests, and to go on to college. And that is just what they needed at North Dallas High 5 years ago.
In 1985, the only people that had cameras up here were people taking pictures of students stabbing each other, hitting each other, or stealing from each other. Thank God that's no longer here at this school.
Charles Hodge is head of the math department at North Dallas High School, an inner city school in Dallas, Texas, with a 95% minority student body. 5 years ago, most of the students never went beyond basic math class.
We were in the bottom. We were ranked in the lower fifth percentile of the school in Texas in 85.
In math?
In math.
We know we have all the positive numbers out here, right? And all the negatives over here.
Hodge says that since 1985, he has used the Saxon textbooks, plus these math tutoring sessions, plus some committed teachers, and that things have turned around at North Dallas High. Math scores are up dramatically, and advanced math enrollment has increased by 4 to 5 times. Joseph Melton is a good example. He is getting straight A's in calculus.
My family is not very educated, and I wouldn't, you know, be the first, you know, to become successful.
He's taken Calculus 1 as a junior. By the time he finishes, he will have 13 semester hours of college calculus plus differential. He can do anything he wants to do in life.
We believe in myth. We believe that there are some people that cannot learn mathematics.
Mary Lester is mathematics director for the Dallas Independent School District.
What students don't we expect to learn?
We do not expect necessarily women. We do not expect Hispanic students. We do not expect black students, and as a result, they don't do well in mathematics.
Lester says she put the Saxon books in North Dallas High 5 years ago because she thought they would change students' attitudes about math.
They removed the fear of mathematics from the children. The children do not feel that they cannot succeed. The children feel that they understand the approach, they understand the method, and they are not hesitant to take additional courses of mathematics.
Math isn't very easy for me to grasp. It takes me a while to get it, and with this book, it's easier because they got a problem in every lesson, and that way I can grasp it by a week or so. I'll understand how to do the problem. And that's what makes this book good.
Hard says the students realize their success in math will help them when they graduate from high school. What you gonna do?
I want to go into journalism or communications.
And you know that all we have to know is 2 times 2 is 4.
I want to go to college, and I know that having a calculus class right now, it'll just help me.
These students need all the help they can get, Hart says, because many of his students have to work an 8-hour job each night after they finish school.
These kids, look at what the world drags on them, what pulls on them. There's more forces for these poor kids than I had as a kid. It's unreal. And they've got to cope with it. And this method is allowing them to cope with it. Because I want these kids to see.
Over the years, Saxon has managed to sell more than 1 million of his textbooks. And he's had success in school systems around the country. But he has had problems, too. San Diego dropped his book when test scores did not go up. And he's been rejected by educational authorities in 22 states. But Saxon says that part of the problem is he's an outsider, not a member of what he calls the math establishment.
I'm not a member of the club.
Really?
Yes.
And so they look down their nose at you.
Well, and also I'm not very nice. These people are responsible for our children's education. They have been doing the job. And I'm very angry about it. And oftentimes I have difficulty containing my anger. And I say things, I lash around and throw my arms around, and I say things that people resent.
Even supporters like Charlie Hard say that Saxon's uncompromising personality creates a lot of problems. And that's what he told the Texas State Textbook Committee when he testified in favor of Saxon's books.
I told them Mr. Saxon was arrogant, he was a pain in the rear end, and he thought he was God's gift to mathematics. I used a little different words, but I meant the same thing.
Right.
All right. But I found that the man is generally, and I told them, even though he's all of these, he's written one good textbook, and that textbook will help our children.
How'd I kill it?
But to Charlie Hodge's dismay, the Texas Textbook Committee voted not to approve Saxon's books, and Saxon refuses to rewrite them to meet Texas educational guidelines. And that has put Charlie Hodge in a very tough spot.
I hear, I don't know if it's true or not, but I hear that they're going to take these books away from you next year. And as far as you're concerned, that's a tragedy. Wait a minute. Are you telling me that this is this emotional a matter with you?
Yes, sir. I love these kids. And I want them to see.
Somebody who cares that much about it, not I.
I care. I think that's why these kids care.
Saxon says he is outraged that the progress Hodge has made at North Dallas High could now be cut short by educational bureaucrats. He is convinced that Hodge's success with his books can be duplicated in schools across the country, and he'd like to prove it. So he says he will provide free textbooks to 500 major high schools across the country for a massive 3-year test, if his critics will do the same.
It's a challenge.
You're challenging school systems around the country.
And it is a challenge to the other major publishers of textbooks. If they have an answer, let's let them come up with it. And let's let them match my offer of $15 million worth of free books. And we'll go mano a mano, head to head, and we'll see who can turn around math education in America.